So in this problem, we need to show that in a group G, every element has a unique inverse. So it's a pretty easy proof, but it's worth doing on your own. So proof. So to start the proof, we'll suppose we have some element X which lives inside G. Now to show that X has a unique inverse means that we have to show that if we have two inverses, they are indeed the same. So suppose X is in G and Y1 and Y2 are both inverses of X. So we'll start by writing Y1. If we show Y1 is equal to Y2, then we are done because X only has one inverse and that's the whole point of the problem. So Y1 is equal to Y1 star. Now we somehow need to involve Y2 and X, so I'm going to put E here. And we can do that because E is the identity. So here we have Y1 star. Now, if I put Y2 here, it's not really going to help because we'll get stuck because then we have Y1, Y2. So what we'll do is we'll put X here so that later we can star it with Y to get E. So this is X star Y2. And this is because Y2 is the inverse of X. The next step, we use associativity. So Y1 star X star Y2. This is by associativity. The next step, this is E star Y2. This is because Y1 is the inverse of X. And the last step, this is equal to Y2. This is because E is the identity. So we showed that Y1 is equal to Y2. So Y1 is equal to Y2. And that finishes the proof, and we've shown that the identity element is unique. It's probably worth noting that in this step here, we use the fact that Y2 was the inverse of X, and in this step here, we use the fact that Y1 is the inverse of X. So we use both conditions to show that, in fact, identities are unique. Every time you do a proof, you should always look back and see, you know, when you used the important stuff. All right, I hope this has helped.